At first glance, Dutch roll might sound like a dance move or maybe a delicious pastry. But in aviation, it's a unique and sometimes uncomfortable motion that every pilot should understand. It happens when an aircraft starts to yaw in a rhythmic, seesaw-like motion, often in swept wing designs. In this video, we'll break down what causes a Dutch roll, what it feels like, and why it matters for both new and experienced pilots. Before we get started, make sure you like this video and subscribe so you don't miss more aviation tips and insights from Epic Flight Academy. Let's get started.
My name is Ray Altmann and I'm the Chief Flight Instructor at Epic Flight Academy. So a Dutch roll is an oscillation usually caused unintentionally where the plane will start to roll and then adversely yaw and continue on this swaying manner.
A Dutch roll is an aircraft motion where the tail wags side to side while the wings rock from side to side, with both movements occurring out of phase. It's caused by aerodynamic coupling between the yaw and roll axes of an aircraft. The term Dutch roll comes from a Dutch skating style, where skaters rhythmically sway side to side, just like an aircraft's tail wagging in a smooth, fish-like motion through the sky. This is sometimes called yaw and roll coupling. When a jet or commercial airliner like a Boeing 737 MAX experiences this instability, it may begin to oscillate. These aircraft oscillations can look dramatic, but are typically manageable with proper systems and pilot intervention.
So compared to turbulence, which usually the plane's going up and down and maybe a little sideways jostling from turbulence, in a Dutch roll, you're gonna feel the plane kind of swaying side to side, so you're gonna be kind of thrown left and right in your seat versus up and down.
In Epic's ground school, pilots learn about the three types of stability: directional, lateral, and longitudinal. Directional stability is an aircraft's ability to resist yaw and stay on course. It occurs around the vertical axis and is controlled by the rudder. If a crosswind pushes the nose sideways, the aircraft realigns itself into the wind. Lateral stability is an aircraft's ability to resist roll and return to level flight. It acts around the longitudinal axis and is managed by the ailerons. If a gust tilts one wing down, the aircraft will naturally roll back to level. Longitudinal stability is an aircraft's ability to maintain or return to a steady pitch. It occurs around the lateral axis and is controlled by the elevator. If turbulence causes a pitch up, the aircraft will naturally return to its trimmed flight path. The flight characteristics of a Dutch roll are distinct from other oscillatory motions like phugoid motion, which involves pitch and altitude fluctuations rather than yaw and roll. Both are important flight training maneuvers covered in pilot instruction to ensure safe and controlled responses.
So at Epic Flight Academy, students do practice Dutch rolls both in the simulator and flying. We will intentionally induce a Dutch roll and practice reducing the oscillations, and we'll practice using coordination, which is your ailerons and rudder inputs equally being applied to create the plane's nice natural coordinated roll to prevent Dutch rolls.
The primary cause of a Dutch roll is an imbalance in stability between yaw and roll. Many swept wing aircraft, including modern commercial jets, are prone to Dutch roll due to their design. Contributing factors include adverse yaw created when an aileron is deflected, resulting in an unintended yaw, a malfunction in the yaw damper system, a critical feature that suppresses Dutch roll automatically, strong crosswind or turbulence, and asymmetric thrust or control surface anomalies.
So a swept wing aircraft is more susceptible to Dutch rolls and is due to the angle of the wing. So if this plane, which has swept back wings, were to roll to the left in this case, the relative wind is more aligned with the chordwise airflow over the wing, which is causing more lift. This also causes more drag, so it will cause the plane to start to lift the wing and yaw the nose towards the opposite direction. And when this happens, the other wing dips, the relative wind now starts lining more chordwise with this wing. It's going to cause the plane to generate more lift and yaw the opposite direction. So it gets stuck in this adverse yaw rolling stage.
At Epic, we teach effective recovery techniques for Dutch roll using coordinated aileron and rudder control. We train our pilots to identify the aircraft oscillations early, apply rudder input and counteract yaw while using ailerons for roll stabilization, and avoid overcorrection, which can lead to a spiral dive or worsen instability. Proper pilot training, aircraft design, and system redundancy help ensure that Dutch roll, while potentially dangerous under certain conditions, can be managed effectively. Phugoid motion is a slow, smooth, long-period oscillation in which an aircraft alternately climbs and descends, continuously trading altitude for airspeed and vice versa. During this motion, the angle of attack stays nearly consistent, and the aircraft responds naturally to pitch disturbances. In stable flight, phugoid motion is typically self-correcting and not dangerous, requiring little or no pilot input. Most modern jets use a yaw damper system that automatically detects yaw and applies rudder inputs to prevent Dutch roll, without pilot involvement.
Yaw dampers are a system installed on lots of large aircraft where the rudder has automated inputs, so computerized systems, that detect oscillations and dampen the oscillations to prevent this adverse yaw or Dutch roll.
In flight training, simulators safely introduce students to Dutch roll behavior. FAA-approved programs like EPIC's Part 141 include video demonstrations to help students visualize and respond correctly. EPIC students fly the Cessna 172 Skyhawk and Piper PA-44 Seminole, both dynamically stable aircraft that can still experience Dutch roll under the right conditions. Understanding Dutch roll goes beyond ground school. It's about knowing how your aircraft moves, how systems like the yaw damper keep it stable, and how to respond if needed. Whether you're flying a jet or training in a Cessna 172, recognizing and managing Dutch roll builds confidence, sharpens your skills, and reminds us that even the sky has its rhythms. Thank you for watching. If you learned something new, make sure you like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel, so you don't miss any new aviation tips and insights from Epic Flight Academy.